In this video, we're going to show you how a solar farm is constructed from beginning to end. We've been invited to the Elmbrook Solar Farm site in Skodak, New York by Eden Renewables. This 36-acre site will produce about 11,000 megawatt hours per year of electricity, enough to power about 1,200 average homes. That's a lot of clean energy from a small piece of land. Here we are at phase one of the construction process. It begins with trucks making roads and pathways to have access and for developing the land into a solar farm.
You've got all this earth moving equipment that's moving soil around, and as soon as soil is disturbed, it becomes sensitive to erosion. So to try and mitigate that, the first step is to put erosion and sediment control measures in. So at your construction entrance, that might be a stone pad for the trucks to drive over. So as they come out of the construction entrance, if there's mud or dirt on their tires, it kind of gets dropped off in the stone pad.
Don't worry, in the end, they'll be replanting grasses and wildflowers to make it even more beautiful than it ever was. Eden ensures that building the solar farm will improve the biodiversity here.
This land had been used for hay, and there was very little biodiversity here. So when we build the solar farm, we're able to implement all sorts of measures that increase the biodiversity.
It's important to have a grid or a layout in order for crews to work efficiently and to know where everything will go.
The bulldozers and excavators that the contractors are using have GPS positioning systems built right into their equipment. So they take the drawings that we develop over the approval and permitting process, and they use a three-dimensional model of those drawings to operate the equipment.
Once all the roads have been created and everyone can get around, they move on to phase two, which is pounding in the pilings. These pilings are what keep the solar panels above ground stable and in place. It's important that the rows are put in the right spot for all the panels to connect in a straight line for the arrays. That's why the workers use GPS to accurately place the pilings in the ground. A laser beam is used to ensure all the pilings are the correct height. This part of the process could take a few weeks to complete. These gears enable the solar panels to follow the sun. As the sun moves across the sky, the angle of the panels will rotate up to 120 degrees, so they always get maximum sunlight.
They're single-axis tracker systems, meaning that they're orientated in the north-south direction, the row of panels, and they rotate and face the east, obviously, face the sun in the morning, and they slowly track the sun throughout the day, facing the west at the end of the day, and then reset back to the east overnight.
These purlins and rafters are what the solar panels will attach to.
This is our golden row. A golden row is essentially a mock-up for the entire system where we build every process at once before we build it in the field. We also have the quality control from the manufacturer as well as for electrical work come out, check if we installed everything correctly, approve our work, and then we continue using the same process all down the field.
Look at how far apart these rows of solar panels are placed. They take up less than one-third of the total land on this site. That leaves enough room for grasses, wildflowers, and natural habitat. Say hello to BESS, the battery energy storage system. BESS stores power for when it's needed the most. It's housed in a standard-sized shipping container. A giant crane lowers the transformers, inverters, and battery storage containers onto the pads.
As you can see, these wires are above ground. One of the benefits is that we avoid trenching, so we're creating a greater ecological benefit within our solar farm by not trenching and disturbing the ground.
So we've got about 40 volts per panel out here combined at the combiner. The inverter inverts it to AC, and out to the road we have around 13,000 volts going out to the road.
We plant wildflower seed mix and grasses. We install bird and bat boxes around the perimeter of the project area. We install scrapes and wood piles to support the amphibians and reptiles. And then we focus on the vegetative screening.
At the end of the useful life of a solar farm, then there's an opportunity to remove the panels, remove the piles, and that land will go back to whatever it was being used for prior to the solar farm being constructed. So that means it could be farmed again, it can go back to wilderness, you can have trees grow back. And so from an impact standpoint, it's a commercial use that has very low or no contamination risk.
With the completion of this project, Eden Renewables is stacking benefits. We are creating green electricity. We're offering a discount of that electricity to the community. We are offering tax dollars to the community. We are implementing an education program for the community, and we're creating a biodiverse solar farm, which improves the environment.